It's Bonnie. Happy Monday. I am back on this very dreary January day, January 22nd. I can't believe how fast this month is going. We're supposed to have an ice storm tomorrow. I don't know if we're actually having it. I feel like it's 50-50 right now. But I was in the mood for some spring, so I stopped at Old Navy yesterday and I got a couple of like these brightly colored spring shirts. This is a different neckline, but I kind of like it. I don't know. It fits like right. And it looks good with my Avon heart necklace. So I was like, I'm feeling springy, even though the weather does not match outside. So what's going on today? Bath & Body Works is having a 2-for-18 on the shampoo, conditioner, dry shampoo, and the men's hair care. Is this a good deal? You know, it's better than the $16.95. It's basically, I would say it's like 40% off. The problem is, I don't know how popular their shampoo is. I got the champagne toast. I've had a couple of these. I've had at the beach. So this is kind of a pearlized formula. I used it. I didn't hate it. I didn't love it. I wasn't really big on using it again. And here's the problem. So this is made with vitamin B, aloe, and vitamin E. The problem is a lot of us are really loyal to our hair care systems. You know me, I use the Avon Propolythera system. I love it. Occasionally, I will throw in like a Lush hair bar. But for the most part, I love my hair care system. One of the reasons I love my hair care system at Avon is because it was formulated for hair. I mean, there's a lot of ingredients that I like in there. There's a royal jelly. Whereas the Bath & Body Works, I feel like this is a generic hair product. It's not like Matrix. It's not like any of the high-end hair products. I don't even feel like it's like a lower-end hair product like Suave. You know what I mean? Like, it's just like Bath & Body Works decided to make shampoo and conditioner. And I don't think that that's a really strong sell other than having the scent. It's kind of like the laundry detergent. It's funny because I feel like the laundry detergent is actually more popular than the shampoo line, but I don't feel like a lot of people are that interested in using shampoo from Bath & Body Works. They have their hair care system in place. That being said, there's a lot of different, you know, scents going on here. A Thousand Wishes, there's At the Beach, Into the Night, Japanese Cherry Blossom. That would be really intense on hair, by the way. They also have a dry shampoo line. None of this stuff is getting the greatest reviews. However, the men's care, I feel like, is a little bit more of a niche market. So they have the hair clay. Remember when Lenny was in here? We got the hair clay. I used the hair clay. I actually liked it. It made my bangs like stand up nicely. And then Lenny had been trying the hair gel and he wasn't like totally sold on the hair gel. He liked the shave gel a lot. The hair gel, he was kind of like, it's kind of like his regular hair gel. And then they have the daily shampoo. Again, I feel like there's not a huge reason to switch over to any of these hair care products. And I think that's going to be tough for Bath & Body Works to maintain in the hair care arena. I mean, if they get strawberry pound cake, I might try it just to see, but I might not. I don't know, because I love my hair care system. So what I think Bath & Body Works should do is focus on more body care type of products because they are Bath and Body Works, not Bath and Hair Works. So again, I'd love to see more bubble bath. I'd love to see more shaving products. I would totally use a strawberry pound cake shaving gel or oil or cream. That would be wonderful. And deodorant. I've been saying this for a long time. I like the formula of the men's deodorant. I actually really, really like it. I would totally use a strawberry pound cake deodorant. So maybe eventually we'll get that. But I kind of feel like the hair care products are just like this outlier, and I'm not really sure where they fit in for Bath and Body Works. So let me know what you think. I'm just not sold on the hair care. I feel like it probably takes up a lot of shelf space. They have a big kiosk in the middle of the room. With all this hair care stuff, and I don't see a lot of people buying it. Maybe they are, and I don't see it. I don't know. I just am not totally sold on shampoo at Bath and Body Works. I'll stick to my other stuff. I'd rather see a really like amazing spa line. Like seriously, bring back True Blue Spa. That's where Bath and Body Works, I think, their customer base lies, is that spa stuff. Anyway, let me know what you think. I'll see you guys later. Bye bye.